Hey guys, back with a very special beer. This is from Cantillon. It's an old one. We believe it's 25 years old. You might have just saw the video of us opening, but it's Brabantiae from world-renowned Cantillon 25 years ago. It's hard to read the label. I guess a lot of these bottles were in a cellar that got flooded, so the label's all goofed up. But the beer was carbonated. It smells awesome. It has that big-time basement funk character, which is awesome. A lot of like stone fruit. Again, a little bit like almost a honey note. Maybe some pleasant type of oxidation notes from being this old, but.
No.
Yeah, a lot of kind of apricot, peachy notes to it. So, a nice carbonation for beer this old. Stick in, cheers. Falls in aroma really well. Basement funk, a little more tartness, a little more of that lemony tartness. That kind of old, musty cellar basement funk is really prevalent. It's really mellow, balanced at this point. Just what a treat. This is a phenomenal beer, and all these years later, it's pretty amazing how well this is held up. Definitely like a, maybe like an under-ripened stone fruit character that kind of goes into somewhat ripened to go with that lemony funk. But wow, what a beer. Just a great big thanks to Chris and Robert for letting me have the opportunity to try this beer. Probably will never again. I don't know if anyone has these around. And so you might never see a review of this beer once again. So ball's in your court. Don't drink beer. Until next time, cheers.
All right, opening. Is it Brabantiae? Am I pronouncing that right?
I don't know. I call it Brabantiae.
But Brabantiae.
It's 25 years old, we figured out.
25, yeah.
The cork is, it's in there, but it's carved. So that's a good sign. Hoping it doesn't break. No pressure on the current Stone AHA Rally collaboration winner here. This beer will be out in September, so we'll plug that while he's opening this bottle.
Damn, the cork looks muddy.
Woo! Yeah.
Bad babies.
Oh, doing a good job though. Doing a good job. Teamwork, guys.
Teamwork.
Yeah. The other R in the R&R Coconut IPA.
Like
ooh.
Now, look at that thing.
Oh no, might be breaking.
It's pretty low in there.
I think it split off, so what about a CO2 opener?
I don't know, I'm not familiar with that.
Okay, so let's try that here.
Yep.
Look at the bubbles, that's impressive.
It's definitely carbonated, folks.
I've got some Brabantiae label on my hands.
Anyone want to tick that? No. Someone have a glass ready in case this thing just goes.
Oh geez, yeah.
Cause I mean it's This is a fancy opener. I've never seen a CO2 opener.
I think I've had a CO2.
Uh-oh.
You have like all the craziest toys.
CO2 there.
Maybe it wasn't sat in there correctly.
Or is it possible that there's
so this will be the oldest beer until we open another beer later. Come on.
There we go.
Whoa!
Wow.
You okay? So yeah, we did get it open. Who's gonna do the honors of pouring this?
That's
rubber. So yeah, that's
I don't wanna be any part
CO2
of this.
CO2 opener.
I'm scared to open
the
mine.
The bottle might blow up.
So I guess the pin goes in, shoots CO2 in there, and just busts it out.
Don't make sense why it's so loud now, there's a lot of CO2 in there. Yeah.
So the cork was really in there. Look at that old.
Have you ever used this?
The wines, yeah. Wow. It just pops it out.
Oh, it's real quick.
All right, who's gonna pour it?
I'll pour.
Okay, go for it.